by going in two directions. So from your middle back down, you want to really ground into the pelvis and feel your sitting bones. And then from the middle back up, a lot of times we'll say lift the heart, but really we want to lift the back body and the heart goes with it. So there's a lifting up on the back line of your body, all the way up through the back of the neck. Now notice if there's tension around your shoulders or your ears, and find some release around the jaw, the hairline. And then begin to feel your breath move. Notice where the breath lands and where the sensations in the body become more loud, I guess I could use that word. For a lot of people, it will be in a certain area of their body, like their back or their shoulders or their hips. So the first step in finding a meditative state is to simply become aware and present. Now see if with your breath and with the calming of your mind, you can find some more even energy through the body. So a little more equal energy downward and upward and home. And I'd like to remind everyone why the breath is so important. One of the reasons is obviously that we're alive and we breathe, so that's positive. But as we age, when we lose those either tone in our muscles or we lose just strength in our core muscles, even at rest, we take in less breath. So using the posture and using the breath to tone the muscles around the trunk is really important. One of the reasons that they talk about the breath so much in yoga philosophy is for that exact reason, is to keep your trunk healthy and keep your body vibrant and full of vitality. So breathe in and fill all the way up and focus on the back of your ribs. And when you exhale, grow taller through the crown of your head. Soften your shoulders down and think about creating space from the inside out. Now visualize your body without looking in the mirror. So without any visual stimulation, inner visualize your body, the outline of your body here. If there's any tension in your thumbs, try to release tension around your fingers and your wrists. Continue to look for length north to south. Take a two more breaths together in the seated position. Think about lifting the breath from the center of your body. So from the middle back, the lower belly, lift up with the breath, and then push down through the pelvis with those same muscles. One more time in. Let your breath move slowly. Control. Eventually, we want to come to 8 breaths per minute in the form of pranayama practice. Lengthen the back of your neck. Exhale. Open up your eyes, take your right palm out to the side by your right hip and float your left arm straight over the shoulder. Take a breath in and bend over to the right. When you bend to the right, notice if your ribs shifted back left. Try to lift up the right ribs, try to find space. And when you exhale, really draw down through that left hip. Float the other way, just take your left hand down to the mat and inhale, lift up your right arm. And take that big side body yawn through the right. Maybe even spin your right shoulder open slightly. And now come back through center. Take your hands behind your back, lower or somewhere else. Open up the shoulders. When you open up the shoulders, draw your ribs to the blue wall behind you. breath, holding your ribs back. That's it. Now look up slightly with the gaze without lifting the chin. So think about just the chin still will stay parallel, but you want to lift up the gaze. Good. And then release on your exhale. Walk your body into a fold. So walk your hands forward, take your forehead any amount toward the floor. Just stretch your arms. Now when you fold, pull back into your pelvis. So let that be the gauge for your fold. Pull back into your pelvis. If you ungrounded, down dog here. Inhale, high plank. over your wrists. Walk forward, walk forward. Middle back leading the way. Middle back leading the way, bringing you all the way up into the deepest height that you can manage. Good. Now take your feet wide and come into ragdoll. Outer edges of your elbows, wrap them with your hand. Let your day literally drip from your head. So you can walk your hands a little bit left and then come into pigeon just for a moment, just to breathe into the hips a little. If it's a better fit to go into lizard, come into your lizard lunge. We're here just to wake up the hips, pressing the outer edge of your front shin and foot. Try to roll your right hip back for space. Just think about creating space along your right ribs. Back into downward dog with your right leg lifting. So come to reverse cheetah and then send your right leg high. Now we're going to step our right foot between our hands and we're going to lower the left knee down. When you lower the left knee down, I feel like it's always handy to use a block under your right hand. Push heavily into your right foot. So one way that you can test this is by lifting up your left knee and seeing if you can actually transfer weight. So make sure you can feel, you don't have to do that, but you can feel that press down, kind of like you're ready to lunge or launch forward. Okay, so push that far into your right heel. Good. Now from there, reach your arms overhead and then take your right elbow to your right thigh. Push that far into your right heel as you bend over to the right. Just a slight arch to the right. That's it. Now come back upright with your two hands and then sweep your right palm down by your right hip, and without rotating your pelvis, use your inner thighs to hold your pelvis forward. Twist as far as you can. Now focus on pulling with your right hip crease and lifting your left hip. Tip down into a twist. So pull your hips back as you reach your right arm high. You're not lunging forward. Your legs are in a 90-90. So pull your left hip up and back. There you go. So focusing less on the hip flexor stretch and more on the rotation of the torso. Breathe in. And on your exhale, pull your left ribs to the right more. Squeeze under your upper body. But take your top hand down to the mat. Step back for your standing. Step back for your downward dog. And option here to move through a flow, or option just to hold down dog and walk out of the feet. We'll come into pigeon on the left side. Bring your knee to the outside, just to the outside of your left wrist. Now, if you find that this bothers your knees, take a hip block under your hip, through your left hip. Let the breath flow to all the tight spots around the left glute, the front of the right thigh. Side bend, left arm
This is the calling, have you heard?
Breathe in.
With all the love I've
seen. See if you can subtly drop your ribs back. It feels as though you're lifting like the flesh of your belly under your ribs, kind of like churning your core. Like a hollow body. Alright, arms upright, breathe in. Hold your pelvis still, twist down to the left. So without letting the pelvis move, you're going to take a twist. Pull your left hip crease back and lift up your right. Right hand.
Up there, that's it.
wide feet, right? So bring your torso there too. Push down into your 2 feet and feel your body exactly vertical. Tip back for peace. Don't break the center. Feel the center every time you move. Then walk your hands down to the mat. Bring your low rib cage over your wrists, looking forward. Hold that. Step into plank. Don't let the shoulders move back. Chaturanga.
Breathe in.
continue to inner spiral your pelvis, just to a touch. Good. Breathe in. Lift higher through the top arm. Think about strength. Literally, you can barely feel this other than your feet. Rise back up for more. Oh, no, that's wrong. Sorry. Right hand down to the mat. Lift up your right heel. Make sure you don't try to cross the midline. There you go. And then go into your simple twist with ease. Or grab your foot and move. Nice long break. Move into your big toe. Breathe here, yogis. Feel the breath. Where is it? Where do the sensations in the body speak? I forget where to go from here. I believe you moved for a vinyasa. That's why I'm holding everything locked. Inhale, left thumb. Exhale, twist and go to the right.
now. I want you to push in anything that was hard in your day. Push it through this crunch, through this twist. Now, go ahead and pull your knees into your chest. Wrap your avoid the word grab. Touch your ankles with your fingertips and don't let them move. Rock and roll up to boat pose. Don't let your fingers move from your ankles. Okay, try it again. We got to try that again so you guys can understand. So don't let the fingers move off of the ankles. Roll up to boat pose. Inhale. Good. Exhale, straighten the legs. Heels press. Rise up for chair pose. Inhale, sink low. So we're so strong, hopefully, through our joints, our the muscles that wrap up around near the joints, that we can get low. We can get high in the heart, down heavy through the heels and the toes, but we can find equal energy. Hands come into heart center. I think we twisted left first on our back, so let's go to the left. Hook your right elbow across your left thigh. How is that for you? If it torques anything, lift back to a straight spine. Push down into your feet. Option to take a chaturanga, but option to just move up and back into down dog.
possible, brightly lift the back leg, making a T shape with your lifted leg and torso and a trunk or a foundation with your standing leg. Hug your left inner thigh to the right. That's it. Chair pose, breathe in, yogis. Inhale, focus. Exhale, hands back, heels high. Emphasize the fold of your hip. This will help your balance. Go into crow, or ignore that one, see where you are. Forward bow, let it fall. Step back, everybody, to high push-up plank.
Right side pelvis, just a little. It'll help you get into a little more of your inner.
rise for Warrior One, we find that final push of peace in the body, even though we may be feeling tired or experiencing these thoughts of wanting to be scattered or fragmented. Think about holding your mental center. Bring your right hand down to your right hip. Lift up your right heel. Pour the weight straight over center of left heel. Push right heel back.
Squeeze. Spin your thighs down to the floor.
chest for happy baby. Breathe in. Happy baby pose. Try to get the soles of your feet skyward if possible. And then once you get that, try to take your tailbone back to the floor. So it's going to feel like you're arching or trying to arch your lower back. Quality of your breath in and out. it shimmers in the air in its very presence, and we see it. We see it in those moments when we get into the flow state. We see it during the explosion of power in just the right timing. And we see it in the withholding with patience. We hear it when we dare to speak the truth of what is without trying to control the outcome. It vibrates with the music of life and it dances on the wind. It breaks forth from the trees and it launches us into our purpose. It's just as clear as the shining sun or the crystal air on a cold winter day. It settles into silence, but few of us see it, few of us grasp it. There is a quality of stillness so rare that I am bared to my very marrow of my bones when I touch it. Yogis, I will close our practice tonight. You can roll over to one side. Your right side is preferable just for your digestion. Certainly go left if that's where you want in. Bring ourselves to our seat. Just again pausing the way that we started in stillness and breath and just collecting ourselves, bringing everything back to center. Thank you all for sharing this time with me this evening, this good energy, the focus, the strength, the courage, the peace, the stillness. The light in me honors the light in each and every one of you. Namaste.
Namaste.
Thank you.
Honestly, if I can continue, or if that's when my vibe is going to start going on the downturn. But I don't know.
Well, they did. This was a couple years ago before I met them. And I have mobility issues in my shoulder, so I wasn't doing all the chaturangas, and she like got on me for it. And I was like,
you know what that was, Wendy? That was
my knee.
Johnny Shoshana. Yeah, my knee was giving me issues, but that's my own fault because I sit Indian style all day at the computer. So that's my fault.
My God.
I should not do that.
I don't know even how you do that, but I have, like, I have a borrowed ACL, so. I mean, it's not, I'm not giving it back, it's mine now. so I guess it's not really borrowed. But.
Oh, Lord of me.
It's not.
Okay.
That was amazing.
I was literally, I was like, shit, we're supposed to be doing flying splits, and I'm not doing that.
No.
But